Good Monday morning, St. Thomas More. Today is Monday, January 21st. Today is the last full day of classes prior to the start of final exams for semester one. Yesterday in the Sunday Gospel from John, we learn of the well-known miracle performed by Jesus at the wedding at Cana, at which Jesus turned water into wine. When at the wedding, there was no more wine for the guests, Mary, mother of Jesus, intervened and asked her son to address the problem. Jesus replied that his hour has not yet come, meaning that it was not time yet for Jesus to reveal himself as the Son of God and to perform miracles. Nonetheless, an obedient son cannot disregard a request from his mother, and Mary said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Thus, Jesus performed his first of many miracles at the wedding at Cana. We are told that his disciples believed in him. Our faith has us believe in Jesus and that he is the Messiah, Son of God, sent to earth to suffer, to die, and rise again in redemption for our sins. Today, the church recognizes St. Agnes, patron of young children and young girls and children of Mary. In our prayers, let us remember all who suffer from physical, emotional, or mental illness. We also remember those who have passed from this life. We remember the soul of Mr. John McPhee, past principal of Cathedral and of St. John de Brebeuf, who passed away on Friday afternoon. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace. We now pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear God, help us to always strive for excellence. May we be able to give all we can to attain our personal best. Give us the eyes to see and the gift of prudence to recognize our achievements of excellence, despite the standards of the world. We also pray that we will be instruments for others, enabling and empowering them to be excellent. Amen. St. Thomas More and St. Agnes, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, good morning once again, St. Thomas More. Thank you to all who participated in school activities, after-school clubs, and athletics throughout the semester. Now, last week, co-instructional athletics did end on Thursday, and we do have photos to share with you. Last week's senior boys basketball. On Thursday, boys played basketball and the girls played volleyball. And here are some photos taken by Mr. Jerry Graham at Cathedral. And it was quite a stunning game and a victory for St. Thomas More Knights. So congratulations to all who represented STM at events, including the robotics, girls volleyball, boys basketball, girls and boys hockey, and swimming. So well done. And now that the athletics are over for a short period of time while we've got exam, remember that this Wednesday is day one of final exams. So you have a class in period one. Wednesday is the first day of exams. All students have received the student info package. It is also available online on the school website. Please be aware of when and where your final exams are written. Continue to prepare and study, and to be sure you are all caught up on your work for assessment and evaluation. Also, last week we did have the grade 9 EQAO mathematics for students who are taking applied and academic math this semester. So a big thank you to all our teachers and other staff for helping to facilitate this, especially the teachers in the mathematics department, and to all the students who were so diligent and who prepared for it as well. So have a great day. Best wishes on your exams. Now on to further announcements.
Good morning. This is a message to all potential grade 12 graduates. Deadline, March 29th. That is the last day that you can pay your grad fee of $80. As far as I know, we only have approximately 125 students that have actually paid their grad fee. First come, first serve for guest tickets. So the sooner you pay your grad fees, the better tickets your guests will receive. Also, the ones who pay early will also have their name thrown into AHAP where they can obtain potentially 4 grad tickets for their guests instead of 3. So deadline, March 29th, sooner the better. After March 29th, there will be a $10 late fee. And after April 12th, no tickets, no guest tickets will be available. And also, you will not be able to participate in the graduation ceremony. You can still graduate, but you cannot participate. Next, this message will be to all grade 9, 10, and 11 math students. Anyone interested in writing the University of Waterloo Math Contest on Tuesday, February 26th, during period 2, is asked to speak to their math teacher. And if you don't have math this semester, come see me in room 320 or 350 during periods 1 through 5 to register. There is a $5 deposit, but you do receive that back once you write the contest. So once again, grade 9, 10, 11 math students wishing to write the University of Waterloo Math Contest, please see me or your math teacher for information. Thank you and have a great day.
Just a few important reminders regarding exams, especially for those students who will be writing in alternate settings or have alternate arrangements. First of all, if you are writing with resource, your exams begin at 8 a.m. So please report to room 217, the resource room, at 8 a.m., half an hour early, and don't forget to bring your textbooks. If you are writing in Student Success, exams begin at regular time, and again, don't forget to bring your textbooks with you so to avoid an outstanding account. If you are an English language learner, you will be writing in your classrooms, and you will be escorted to the library if you require some extra time. And also, that also applies to some students who have special arrangements through their guidance counselor and Student Success as well. If you have any questions about where you will be writing your exam, if you have an alternate situation, please speak to your Student Success teacher, your resource teacher, or your guidance counselor. Thank you.
Hey STM, we're here from your student council and prefects, and we'll start off with some activities. Attention grade 12 graduates, a reminder to hand in your completed community service forms to the guidance office. Those grade 12 students who have not completed their hours are asked to do so as soon as possible. You may have some available time to do so once you have completed your exams over the next week and a half.
There will be art club today in room 329 following dismissal.
French tutoring will be held today after school in room 344. All French students are encouraged to attend.
Also, an important message from your student services department. Any students wanting to make a guidance appointment during exam week will be able to start booking online tomorrow afternoon. Any students wanting to make a guidance appointment during the first week of second semester will be able to start booking online after exams have finished.
Also, night school is open for registration on your MyPath account.
Thanks
STM. Hey STM, I'm back again. So I'm gonna talk about prom. Ticket sales are done. You cannot buy a ticket anymore. Also, prom forms for your guests and table forms are all done. Yeah, you should have handed them in already. And for the date of prom, which is February 1st, if you were an STM student or someone in high school, I'll say, all you have to bring is your student ID. But if you were in, and if you purchased online, just your student ID. If you purchased in school, you need the ticket as well as your student ID. And if you are not from STM, like let's say you're going to MAC, you need to bring a driver's license. And if you bought a ticket in school, your guest brought it, then you need to have that ticket there as well. Other than that, STM, time is now 8:35. Have a great day.